Woohoo! Oh, I get a funny feeling inside of me, just walking up and down. Maybe it's because I'm a Londoner that I love London town. Welcome back to Big Hub the Nerd and today's episode of The London Journey as we start season 10. Season 10. Damn, that's a lot of seasons. With Crystal Palace in the Premier League as we are honing in, looking for our first opportunity to snipe one of the bigger clubs. Tottenham, Arsenal, or Chelsea are the ones we are looking to move to for our last jump in the journeyman. But we could easily make Europe with this Crystal Palace team. So today we start the season with a game against Tottenham. We are away to kick off the season. We then got United after. It's not a great start, but great first two games. And then Leicester, West Brom, Birmingham got a slightly easy run. And then we finish the season with West Ham, Chelsea, Man City, Arsenal, and then Newcastle, Wolves. That's going to be a fun. You will notice as well that QPR are in the Premier League. The team that we left behind when we jumped ship have got themselves promoted. They've still got Bolker. He was a goalie brought in. Alimbi's still playing. We brought him in. Daly's still going strong. We nearly bought him for... who are we? Crystal Palace. Redan's there as well. Other than that, they've replaced a lot of the players that we had in. Dozzle's there. We brought Dozzle in. Himas we had there. Amici, Gould. Okay. Wow, yeah. They've replaced quite a few of them. Quite a few of them. So, yes. That's what we're going for. Arsenal, Chelsea or Tottenham. Preferably Arsenal because Jelani Fletcher is at Arsenal. If we can get the Arsenal job, we win. But, you know, might not happen. So, let's go through then the transfers that we've made for this season. And we spent all of our money. We got 9 million left of the budget, 59. And I've had to balance it a few times. You see, we've been accepting and rejecting offers for lots of different players. But we've only brought in two players. We spent big. One of them, yeah, spent way, way too big. So we brought in two players. One is a right back, Mihail Boksha. Yep. 16 million we paid for him just up front. He starts at Dinamo Kiev. He is a regen for Dinamo Kiev. Was bought by Juve for 5 million, loaned out for a season, loaned out for another season, back to Dinamo. And then, we bought him for 16 million. So they've got a bloody good deal. But if you look, he's been averaging sevens for a lot of the season, or very close to sevens for every season he's played in. Happy with that. He's a right back, he's a wing back, naturally, or a full back. Obviously, we're playing him on support, but he has that ability. Like, he's just very good physically, good, great determination, great decision making. He's already seen, we've already seen from him actually quite a few like good little signs that he's the right back we need, someone we can rely on rather than Foster and Hoiva, who we've been struggling with. And the next one is Jonathan Panzo, name you will know, centre back. We paid 49 million for him. Yeah, it was too much money. So he was starts at Chelsea, obviously, was sold to Monaco for 2.7 million, loaned around a bit. And then Everton bought him for 10 million. He's had a fair few seasons at Everton. They got relegated last year, so down in the Championship now, and he wanted to leave, and I just saw him. He's like not had sevens, but he's been averagely okay as a defender. He's not amazing. He's good physically. He's only 26, so he's got his best years still to come. His marking, passing, tackling and stuff need to improve slightly, and I'd like to get him up to closer to 15s. Ideally, is what I was looking for, but couldn't really find him. Position at 15s. His mentals are very good as well. Good anticipation, good composure, good positioning. Physically, he's strong. So he's I would say, comparable to Wilmot. We didn't pay all of that 49 million up front. We did the reason we had to pay so much is because we only paid about 10. I think it was 10 or 11 up front, and the rest of it we pushed to future years because it's the only way I could afford to bring someone in. Tried to look at other defenders who were slightly older, paying for like 29, 30-year-olds. They were all wanting 30 million as well, so I didn't have the money for it. So I went in. He's English. He can play. He's a ball-playing defender if we need him to be, but we'll probably hone him back to just being a centre-back. And he's left-footed as well, so he's our new centre-back partner. So only two players brought in. That's probably the least amount of players I've brought in a season so far to date in the 10 seasons that I've gone. We've got two players going out for free. We've got Bishop and McCann have gone out on loan, as well as Dominic Bettis. Don't know who he is. And then we sold one player, which was Ranelli. So we sold Ranelli, the centre-back, for 7.5 million. Just got him out quickly because we obviously had someone in. We had Panzo come in. I don't need another one. So we've balanced that way. If we look at tactics, nothing's changed. We just got Wilmot Panzo at the back now. And we will have Boksha if he hadn't have got injured, would have been in at right back as well. So only a few changes. We're going to play Guest from the beginning, Scott Guest, and then have Højbjerg and Goretzka rotate in the second role, as Højbjerg is now 32 and Goretzka is 32 as well. I don't want to play them both full time. Two 32-year-olds running my midfield is a little scary. So we get the youngster in there to help with the running, and then we're keeping the attacking lot again. Brewster's injured, otherwise he would be in. But we would have Brewster, Jones, Carvalho and Zian up top. Brewster and Zian have been scoring goals for fun in the pre-season. We won all of our games. I think we won all of our games. We let in two goals. We scored six and then one and then four and then five and then five. Goals are coming. It was American opponents. So, you know, take that with a pinch of salt. But we are looking good for our money. We've got Ethan Foster going to start, but I'm actually going to switch him out for whoever. And that's the team I think we're going to go for to start. We had bids come in for however. I was trying to push him up. They all were bidding so low. And I was like, I need to make this Panzo money back. Give me a bit more. Højbjerg had bids in. One of them came in right at the very end, up to about 16 or I think it was about 16 or 17 million with loads of add-ons. And I was like, nah, bugger it. I need to keep him. But now, like, think about it. 32, I could have cashed in. But if we don't need money, and I don't think we need the money, let me look at the finances quickly. Now we're rich. We've got 7 million in the bank. If we don't need the money, why would we spend it? Let's keep him in. It does mean our bench is looking a little light, I would say. We've got Ryan Giles coming. He's got a few goals in the preseason. The 23-year-old, we've kept him in. Very quick. Has got some good potential as a striker. We've also got Culpepper and Smith Rowe hanging around. Smith Rowe had some bids again. Nothing that was high enough to warrant selling him. Although I did see Haaland, you know, the youngster who's been at Arsenal. He's the guy that's got like 9 goals in the under-20s World Cup. He's up for sale for 28 million. I kind of wanted to bring him in, but I can't afford him unless one of these guys went. None of them got bought, so end of the game. So I think we're looking kind of light in the backup, but I'm still happy with the squad and happy to start the season. We're aiming for, I think, in the Premier League, we're aiming for sixth. I want sixth or seventh. I want to actually, seventh. Let's start and finish in the same spot. Seventh will hopefully squeeze us into European places, which will be mental. We're predicting something like 14th or 15th. So we're going to go big, real big. So squad is going to have to begin to Panzo. That's fine. In he comes, number four. And we start our first game in the Premier League season of season 10 of the London Journeyman. 10 damn seasons. 10 seasons and Harry Kane and Dele Alli are still leading the Tottenham line. Oh, God. Okay, so let's go. So if we've got... Let's revenge. Straight in. First day of the season. Revenge. Tottenham do us over. Let's do them over. We need to start becoming one of the dominant... Oh, Lawwell's good, I remember now. One of the dominant London clubs. Or if not, we need them to lose. So they sack their manager. And we can then move them, become one of the managers of the top London clubs. As Lawwell goes very close. Within 40 seconds. Pavon now. In goes the ball. Kane, oh, cleared. Oh, come on. Season 10. And we get some FM cheese with the first goal against us in the season. So what happens here? Kane heads in. Højbjerg heads out. Lawwell clicks. And then it just plays ping pong with four or five people and goes in. Brilliant. Right, here we go. 10 minutes. Tottenham coming out from the back now into Arthur. This is where our tactic just doesn't work. I can feel it happening already. Kane. He goes out. Lawwell. Lawwell cutting forward. Out to Almidra. Pavon. Into Dele Alli. Oh, come on. Same old shit. Long range effort. It's not exactly the start I was going for. Look at these tiny little short range passes they're playing. And Dele Alli hits it. Top corner. Madahibi into Jones. Nicely done. Right, come on. Oh, you're letting mid-fucking wingers do you over here. Guys, wingers. Wingers are tackling you. Wingers are known fucking weak tacklers. Diaz, good header on. Oh, CM was close. But remember, it's not a full-strength squad. Our new right-back and Brewster are not playing. Brewster scores a lot of goals. Almendra. Out to Frankel. Panzo, what are you doing? You stepped off. Pavon's in. Oh my God, that was close. Markovic now, throw inside. Panzo heads clear. Jones, and that's it, keeps hold of the ball. Carvalho into Højbjerg. Madahibi. Long ball forward. Zian keeps it. Carvalho now coming forward. In he goes. Diaz. Oh, that's the one that Brewster would have scored. Diaz, come on. That's the goal we score. That's the goal we're going to score so many of this season. Carvalho now into Hueva. Puts the ball into the defender. And then Cavalli's offside. Struggling slightly. Oh, I can't believe Diaz didn't score that as well. That's annoying. That's our go-to goal. Jones now into Zian. Yes! Brahim Zian, first goal of the season for him. Curtis Jones with the assist. We're 2-1. 17 minutes in, there's been three goals in this opening London derby. What a game to start the season. Jones does well here. Charges, lays it inside. Zian lifts it with his left foot. It's a great strike. However, now into Jones. Let's find our feet inside Carvalho. The Triquartista finds Diaz, and Diaz doesn't miss the second time. Oh, baby. 2-2. Oh, hang on. Is he called it? Oh, he's not called it for offside, is he? He wasn't offside. No, easily. Oh, he was just offside. Diaz, why? I celebrated it so hard. Okay, goal disallowed. Zian now on the ball. Out to Carvalho. He's got four men to his left. Look at the way we're going. Diaz, he's got to be onside now. Miles on. Guest! Okay, we're looking good though. We are looking good for our money now. We've settled slightly. They had two freaking shite goals. We scored two good goals. One of them may have been offside. Time to push, boys. Hueva. Oh, he's at the bar. He's fighting for his position here because as soon as Boksha is back, he is going straight in. Gaston Diaz not playing so well to start. That's not good. Frankel, good block. Again. Oh, no, come on. That hit someone again. With the bullshit goals, Tottenham. With the bullshit goals. What happened here? This like lost all its pace and then were moved, which means it took some sort of deflection. So a great block by the ball. They follow it out. It clips through the defender. It goes through the defender. Of course, because the defender is made of nothing. He's a ghost defender. However, down at 6.2. Nothing like your right back playing at 6.2 when you know you bought a new right back because your right back always plays at 6.2 and the fucker got injured before the season starts. Fucking football manager. Pavon. Into Almendra. Panzo, come on, don't get wrong footed here. I spent big money on you. I can't return you either. However, clears. Markovic. Good block. Carvalho. That's it. The assist is on. Counter. Carvalho. Oh, bad ball, Carvalho. Panzo comes across. Hoiberg starts it again. Inside. Jones. Jones. Gap. Oh, Jones. Don't give that man space because he will punish you. Nicely done. 3-2. In the first half, five goals in our opening game of the season. Season 10 is going to be fun. I can feel it. Hoiberg inside. What a ball. And Jones. You don't give him that much space. The man's a beast. Diaz playing at 6.4. Not great. Guest 6.5. Madahibi, Hueva, and Wilmot all playing terribly as well. I'll get Hueva off. He's motivated, I suppose. He could come back. We'll give him a little shout. The defenders will give a shout at halftime. Panzo's playing well, though. He's holding them together. Okay, halftime. We're going in. We'll go for an assertive. Show me something else, actually, in the second half. That covers them all. We're losing. We can still shout at them. One or two of you is doing all right. Majority, though, crap. And we all get shouted at as a team. Diaz is nervous. I'm just going to do a little demand more on all those guys that are all real. Wrong button. Real low. Don't let this be a goal because I'm not looking. Oh, Lowell. Good save by Hansen. All those guys. Just give them a single demand more. Get them all motivated. I need to see some movement in the next 5 minutes. Frankel now hits the wall. The sub is being warmed up. Kane, good block. Guest into Diaz. Diaz needs to come off. What is he fucking doing? What was that? He just kicked the ball off. Ryan Gill. He's left-footed, though. Smith Rowe is a... I'm going to go Culp. Smith Rowe is more of a playmaker. Guest is in there. Foster in. Okay, let's leave the middle. Let's leave the middle for now. Two subs. Diaz, because he just kicked the ball for no reason. That was the final straw. Gets it on the left. Turns. Boots out. No, I'm not having that, mate. And then Hueva's done shite, so Foster's on. But Foster tends to do shit as well. Great slide there. What's good? Foster's come on and there's a VAR. Okay, Foster's come on and Foster's given away a penalty and been sent off. Oh my God. How long was he even on the pitch for? This is why I bought a right back. The right back I had on was playing bad. Fair dues. Bring on Ethan Foster, who is on for what, a minute? When was he subbed on? He was subbed on the 57th minute and he was sent off on the 66th. He was on for 9 minutes before he got sent off. And we're 3-2 down to Tottenham. And I don't have a defender to bring on. I don't know who I bring off because I've made all the subs for everyone else. I can't really bring Jones off, can I? Let's be honest. He's playing well. Carvalho's going to come off for Nesvig. Nesvig's going to drop back. Hoiberg can play as a DM. Oh, that's not a bad move. Move more back. Have a more attacking. Then bring Jones in here as a DLP. I mean, it seems like a weirder move, but we'll do it. And we'll see how we get on. It means we've got more attacking outlet as our right back. But we're going to go down now. It's going to be 4-2. What a ridiculous, ridiculous game. My right backs have been the main talking point of the game. I have a new right back that you can't see because he's injured. The one I play is crap. The one then I bring on to replace the crap one gets sent off. And we're now 4-2 down to Tottenham in the first game of the season because of right backs. Wow. Between them, giving away all the goal mistakes for their season in one game. Just love it. You just love it when stuff like this happens. It makes the game better. Brilliant. Pavon scored his first goal because Højbjerg's not a natural right back. It's 5-2. Fucking hell. He's making us look stupid now. Sanchez out to Pavon. They're going to abuse us on this right-hand side because they know he's not there. Maybe I should have put centre back on. God, the ball goes in again. Carvalho, let's go. Come on. Get one more goal. Zian, come on, Zian. Judge the flight of the ball, you bell end. Højbjerg, great work. Great defensive work. I mean, you headed it like a right back. You headed it straight back to the opposition. It's what you do. They are going at us now. At us. We're still on attacking. I refuse to change it. Højbjerg into Guest. Willmott. He's offside. He's got to be a mile offside, surely. Oh. What a letdown of a first game. They started strong. We got back into it. And then we absolutely shit the bed. Markovic now into Kane. Go on, block it, block it, block it. Pavon's there. Block. Come on. Almenda. Arthur. Don't let him score long-range efforts as well. Don't actually take the piss out of me. Oh, one more sub, but I feel like I don't want to bring anyone on. Leave these guys out to just feel the pain. Not really much we can do about it now. Let's just accept, move on, pretend it never happened. Fire both the right backs. We'll play one right back for the entire season. Where's Kavanagh? Let's bring that youngster back up. Madahibi, how are you down at 5.9? What are you doing to play that bad? I didn't have enough money for a centre back, a left back, and a right back. So I banked on the right backs being the ones that needed replacing, but I'm not so sure. I'm really not so sure. So, oh, yes, Ian. 5-3. Again, attacking-wise, we're looking good. Defensively, shocking. Oh, Zerda, I brought on. Zerda was on for a minute. Set up a goal. That's the sort of substitutions I need to make. Not on for 9 minutes. Get sent off. Look stupid that way, don't you? Arredondo. Yes, Zerda. Strong. You're starting next game. 5-3. First game of the season. 8 goals. 1 red card. Oh, 6-3. That wasn't good defensively, though. Who let him get away with that? I don't want to watch anymore. I'm fed up. But look at this, though. We've had the same amount of shots on target. They've just scored double the amount that we have. That shows, again, we've got a slight problem. We've got some work to do. Zian's there. Go on, son. Get a hat-trick. First game of the season. Oh, he's been brought down. Pavon was on fire. No wonder he's on fire. He's up against a freaking weak winger. I'm going to go for aggressive. I'm far from pleased. That was not good. It's not exactly how he wants that. Now we've got to play United and then Leicester. Three games in the week. Oh, my God. Panzo makes debut. McKenna reports. Foster banned for one match. That guy is getting fined. No wonder he accepts his fine. He played 9 minutes of a game. What a pain ass. What an absolute pain ass. But that is that then. So we will leave it there. We start the season letting in six goals. Six goals in our first game. And we wonder why our goal difference is so bad. We scored three though, which is good. We got Man United next. Leicester, West Brom, Carabao Cup, second round, Birmingham. And then we got Swansea, Fulham. We got such a weird set of games. So we'll come back for Swansea, Fulham. Fulham is another London derby, I suppose. So Swansea, Fulham. And then we'll come back for Liverpool QPR after that. So yeah, Swansea, Fulham to do one London derby. Then we got Liverpool QPR for another London derby. Then we got West Ham, Chelsea. Yeah, it starts to even out a bit then, doesn't it? So yeah, we will leave it there. If you have enjoyed this first episode of the 10th season, then smash that like button. Subscribe if you are new. And if you are new, there's 10 seasons to go and watch. Go back and watch them, man. Well, the journey started at Dulwich Hamlet. We progressed through to Leyton Orient. Got ourselves up the leagues. Jumped ship to QPR. Got ourselves into the Premier League. Jumped shipped again to take on Crystal Palace. And now we are getting ready to push for European football with Crystal Palace. Or see if Chelsea or Arsenal fire their manager and take their job. But we'll see. We don't know what's going to happen. 10 seasons, anything can happen. But I will leave it here. As I said, like, subscribe, do whatever you want. And I will see you back next time. Have a great evening. Bye-bye.